does Evermore exist? Why is it the sister album to Folklore? Why did she even need to make, a sister? Like, a sequel to an album? Like, you may think, oh, Folklore's good enough. Like, doesn't even need a sister album? We're finding out why Evermore exists today. And why Evermore was necessary, and it was not just out of random extra writing Taylor did throughout 2020 because she was bored at home and COVID-19 is just miserable. Okay, first we have to discuss Folklore. Why it even needs a sequel. So Folklore is a track with the cabin, obviously. It has the story, the best part of it is the teenage love triangle, okay? Between Betty, James, and August. I'll do a separate video on explaining the whole love triangle in depth if you want. I'm honestly a very in-depth thinker. So, Folklore is basically like, Taylor is just entering the woods. Oh, out of the woods. That's basically the song that was, like, was the intro to all the woods era. She didn't even realize she was going to the woods yet, but when she made Out of the Woods, it was like, she wants to leave the woods. Little did she know that was going to have to do with her future. So, Folklore, Taylor just walked into the woods, you know. It's only her first COVID-19 album. She's just writing as she's bored at home. She's just got into the woods. She's, like, seeing, like, the shallow end of the woods, like, the ocean. For the first time, you know? She's writing about the experiences. To be honest, I was always more of an Evermore girly. It took me multiple listens of Folklore to actually start, like, liking it more, but now I love them equally, and I can't believe I actually used to be a not-so-Folklore fan, but now I love it, and I love all Taylor Swift's albums, but Folklore is, like, the introduction. Folklore basically is, like, we're in a new era. We're not in the bubblegum pink anymore. We're now in naturecore. We're in a new era. And we are going to spend this 2020 in the woodsy core era, is what Taylor's message here is with Folklore. And that's basically how I see Folklore, you know? So, as we enjoy the shallow end of the woods, you know, the birds chirping, it's so nice, there's bright sun. We love the Folklore cabin. We're learning about, in this area, the love triangle that I'll later discuss in a future upload. Okay, then we're gonna get, that is basically the intro. Like, as I'm saying, we just dived into the woods, you know, but it's like, it takes multiple listens to really understand the album and the lyrics. It's still deep, of course, but, like, not as deep as Evermore. It's like, we just got into the woods. So, as we listen to the album, we're slowly walking towards the deep end, but we're still in the shallow. We haven't gone into full deep. Towards the end of the album, we're in the middle of the woods, basically, because with every track from the album, we kept going a little bit. We kept taking one step further into the woods, is how I see it. Because we kept taking one step further, we kept going deeper. Folklore was just the intro to all that. We stop in the middle of the woods, because that half of the woods is ending. The deep half still needs to be fulfilled. So what's gonna cover the rest of the deep, dark woods, the deep, dark part that's waiting around us? We've gotten through the light already. Where's the deep? Well, we will find out through Evermore. Yep. Evermore. Ta-ta-done! Evermore's not a threat, okay? I'm actually a huge Evermore Stanley. Anyways, so, with Evermore, it's basically like Folklore. Except we're going deeper into the woods, you know? We're going deeper into the woods, like, we're walking even further into the woods, you know? It was kind of that way. So it's like, more deep into the woods, which means a lot of deeper tunes. You find a lot more of the deeper songs in Evermore, right? Like Marjorie, which is literally about Taylor Swift's dead grandma. Dead grandma. I'm sorry, Taylor, for calling out your grandma like that. Please forgive me. I did not mean to mention your grandma, who is dead right now, in this video. I am so sorry, Taylor. Anyways, she also writes a track about her grandpa, too, who also has the same... It's in the same area as her grandma right now. Again, I'm so sorry for mentioning your dead grandparents, Taylor, that you were going through this at the time of the writing of this. I'm so sorry. I don't remember the track was in Folklore Evermore, but still. Yeah, it's basically probably towards the end of the album because we're going closer to the middle. Marjorie is definitely in Evermore, though. I mean, why wouldn't it be in Evermore? Huh? Anyways, it starts off with, I like the fact that the album starts off with Willow, you know, because that's basically the middle area. That shows that we're entering even deeper, because I remember once on vacation, I saw a ginormous willow tree, and oh my gosh, was that willow tree beautiful, guys. That willow tree is so beautiful. It was, like, inside, it was, like, a beautiful, like, it was, like, a whole garden inside that willow tree. Like, we just traveled further, deeper there. So, that means we're going deeper into the woods. Already, we're taking, the steps are not one, but two. Because it's the second sister album. So, instead of one step further, it's two step further per each Evermore track. So, that means, at the end of the album, how many tracks are in this album again? Whatever. We're definitely, like, towards, like, the very... We're going towards the dead end of the woods, and we can't go further. We've gone, like, all the way to the end. We've gone to the deepest sec of the woods for this. Literally, the deepest sec here in Evermore. Oh, right. Okay, we're back. So... Another thing I need to mention when it comes to in-depth tracks, Tolerate It, of course, Champagne Problems. Another good track is one that I can't say because this video is going to no longer be for all ages if I say the title because... I don't recommend people under the age of 12 to listen to this unless you're very mature and you can handle that stuff, but don't say the words in the song out loud. Look, I don't recommend listening to stuff with cuss words. I listen to Taylor Swift songs with cuss words, but I never say them out loud. I always, whenever I sing the song, I replace them, okay? I'm naturally a clean person, you know? I don't like to let it get in my head. I like to just replace it. Pretend she's saying something different. So that one is also cussy, but not as crazy cuss words as Tortured Poets, okay? But still enough cuss words to show that it's a deeper album, and it's like, we're so deep, the swear words don't even matter anymore, is what I want to say about the cuss words right now. So we're like deep into the forest. And the closing track of the album, it's like, why is it as deep as... The real reason, it's basically like, we're at the end, there's no trails left. We just gone through the last patch of steps through the woods. We're stuck, it's like a dead end. We can't go any further into the woods because we just gone the furthest we could possibly go based on these deep tracks and this deep listening, you know? Evermore is very more in-depth. I'm actually an in-depth thinker, as you can tell from all the in-depth. That's how I really see the Folklore Evermore era. And I feel like Folklore wouldn't matter without Evermore, you know? Like, Folklore wouldn't be there without Evermore. Evermore wouldn't be there without Folklore. Neither one of them would be there if neither of them would have been there, you know? One needs the other. They can't exist without the other. Also, if we're talking about folklore and Evermore, we have to discuss the Woodville theory.
I think Woodville, that theory that fans had was so smart because it would have been the in-between of folklore and Evermore, because Evermore is the deep woods and folklore is the shallow woods, and the Woodville theory actually makes a lot of sense. And I feel like Taylor Swift was just lying when she said it was a code name for folklore, and I really thought that it was a third album, and I was part of the Woodville Troopers, and I was... And I did not lose hope when Midnight's come out, because I knew there was going to be something related to Woodville. But, guys, technically this era isn't technically over, because we technically got Woodville. Dun, dun, dun! Through the Tortured Poets Department!
Why the Tortured Poets Department? You heard the second half of the anthology. Yeah, I should have said that. Well, that second part, a lot of the tracks seem like the woodsy tracks from Folklore and Evermore, except in between, which is what we need. So I think those were scrapped tracks from Woodville, the 15 tracks that were supposed to be on Woodville, but ended up in the second part of the Tortured Poets Department. Also, it's ironic that it has a second part because Folklore had the second part of Evermore, and it needed the sequel. It not only had poetry, but it also filled in the gap that was missing from Folklore and Evermore. And that second half was purposely to close Folklore and Evermore and was for us Woodville Troopers and were those scrap tracks that Taylor Swift used. And that's why I think that Woodville actually exists, but we don't realize it as well, and why Woodville is an important part in this. So technically, the Tortured Poets Department is connected to Folklore and Evermore, if this theory is correct. Because Tortured Poets is technically, that part of Tortured Poets Department, this double album, is technically the closing of Folklore and Evermore and what we need to complete the era, because it's in the middle of the two albums. You know? It's like we're stepping more towards the middle with this. And then we end, like, towards the end of the middle, and we're about to, and then Evermore takes us to the deep. And Woodville, that's why Woodville, the Woodville theory and Tortured Poets is actually an important part in here. And Taylor Swift technically helped Woodville Troopers, you know, with that. And that is why Evermore is important. And Woodville, I guess. That wasn't the original plan, but I just felt like including it in there, you know, because this ties in very well to the topic. You understand, right?
I am just praying right now that after this planned out video, it gets a lot of views and that people enjoy this. And unlike most analyzations, it's not like 30 minutes long, okay? Look, I sit there and watch those 30 minute longs and it was more brief because it was way deeper than that, okay? But like, it's like 13 or 14 minutes long, which is average and normal for a full video. And I think that's good for an in-depth. I think that's going to be the time for a lot of them. And I have a feeling we have to go. And if you're wondering, you just found out the truth behind Folklore and Evermore and why one needs the other and why the Tortured Poets actually ties in. I hope you enjoyed, everyone. I wasn't even planning on including the Tortured Poets, but it just came to mind as I was scripting this video.